turn to the 17-year cicada. The 17-year cicada emerges from the earth, and for the next few weeks, it looks for its mate. I know, it sounds romantic. Native American legend anthropomorphized the cicada. It suggests that male cicadas are just like human men, and after those human men find love, they transform from their human form over to a bug-like shape. Okay, now this isn't romantic. What we've discovered is that cicadas, just like most insects, have the mating habits of single-cell creatures, unlike mammals. In fact, of all of the insects that we've covered today, I would say that the cicada is the simplest and the least noble in the insect kingdom. All right, see you guys next week.
Professor Lufkin?
Yes.
Do you think that perhaps in the insect world there is a possibility of true love?
True love, insects. You sound like my father. He was a romantic. If you plan on projecting love onto insects, then there's no place for you in science. Science does not recognize love.
But how do we know? How can we know?
Science. Science.
Professor Lufkin?
Yes.
I was wondering if maybe I could have an extension on my paper. My boyfriend kind of surprised me last night and...
No extensions, okay? The paper is due at 4 o'clock. And scientists have partners, not boyfriends.
People think entomology is the study of insects, but I think entomology is the study of poetry. I mean, insects are nature's poems, are they not? Each thorax a stanza, each antennae a rhyme. So when people call me the world's foremost expert in entomology, I feel like I must correct them. I am the world's foremost expert in poetry.
So beautiful.
So true.
Oh, nasty. Nasty brute.
Oh, shit.
Oh. Sandra!
Hey, sorry, I don't have time to talk right now. I have to get to these cicada reports.
Oh, Sandra, speaking of insects, did you know that the centipede has the most beautiful mating ritual you've ever seen? As a matter of fact, you can come to my eyes here. You can come to my private office if you want. I have videos to show you.
Oh, sure, maybe when I'm not so busy, you know, so thank you. Sandra.
What are you doing? Professor von Steele is clearly into you. You should give him a shot.
God, I don't have time to think about love right now, Rashida. Okay, I have these centipede's reports and the cicada brood. Oh, the cicada brood, what day is it?
Wednesday.
Oh, shit, it's hatching in an hour. I have to go home and document.
Sandra, when are you gonna stop putting work first and start living in the moment?
Once I get tenure.
Currently no 17-year cicadas in sight.
All is calm.
Thank you.
they're here.
The first of the 17-year cicadas have emerged from this ground. This is the beginning of a swarm that will last 6 weeks. These cicadas have been underneath the ground for 17 years, just waiting to peek their heads out in an effort to mate.
For an entomologist, this is like Christmas.
There appears to be something coming from the ground. A mole or a vole or... Trees. Cicada receive their primary nutrients from sap, but he doesn't seem satisfied.
Fuck me. I need to fuck.
He's attempting intercourse the way cicadas do, obviously, butt to butt, ass to ass, but he's too big. He also speaks fluent English.
I need to fuck.
Yes. Yes, you need to mate.
But I need to fuck.
Wow, you're so big.
I need to fuck.
You can't mate with other cicadas. You're the size of a human.
So we fuck?
What? No, you're a bug.
I need to fuck.
No, find someone else to fuck. We're not compatible.
The cicadas have emerged. I've spotted an anomaly, the largest cicada I've ever seen. An incredible specimen of Cicadia gigantica. I don't know where it came from or why it came to me.
So where did you disappear to yesterday?
To hang out with the cicadas. I think this one specimen wanted to hang out with me.
Sandra, you have to stop talking about bugs like they're your friends.
This one was different. He was almost human. And I didn't mean to stare, but it looked like he had a very large penis. Usually cicada penises are 1 millimeter, but this one had to be 9 inches long.
Girl, you need some emotional connection, okay? Some real life friends?
But work is my friend.
No, you need to make a move. If you get with Professor von Steele, he can help you with your career.
This paper is garbage.
But I've been working on nothing else at all for years.
But it is so boring. It's like a dead person wrote it. If you present something like this at the symposium, you'll never get tenure.
But I want tenure. I desire tenure.
Then give them something they've never seen before.
Maybe you could do something like more emotional.
And if you need my my help, I am here. Because you clearly need.
You go, girl.
Tenure. How can I get tenure? Put some more emotion in my work? Can we be friends?
No, please, stop. Stop. No.
Want to fuck?
No, that's weird.
I want to fuck.
Do not like.
I want to fuck.
The hunk. The Cicadia hunk. The Cicadia specimen has poor traction skills, low flirtation devices, and is unlikely to mate. I know how to bring life into my symposium.
I'd be your wingman.
Thought I was the wingman.
Well, yes, okay, technically. But I've noticed that you're really bad at picking up mates. You need to be more charming and less bugging.
Hi, love you. Can we fuck?
No. But if you let me, I'll show you how to mate. You're the most unusual looking specimen I have ever seen. Look, why don't you come back with me and stay with me in my apartment, and I will show you the ropes of dating and mating.
You mean fucking?
Boy, you are really hung up on that fucking.
Yes. Yes.
Well, hello. I was just in the area and I thought maybe I'd walk you to work. Perhaps get some toast and spatzel with a side of Splongenspickle. My treat, of course. I know you haven't made tenure yet.
It's very sweet of you, but I'm actually working from home today, so.
I see. Well, at least let me put this into water for you.
Don't come in my house! Stop! Stop!
Jesus fucking shit, fuck jizzing hell, Christ! That's a big cicada.
Yes. I discovered him in the park last night.
Hello.
Oh! He talks?
Yeah.
Sandra, may I speak to you in this room for a moment?
What do you plan on doing with the specimen, Sandra?
Well, he really wants to mate, but he doesn't know how to quite interact with people. He needs help, you know, figuring things out.
A surprisingly competent idea, Sandra. Gain its confidence. Take it under your wing, pun intended, because it has wings, that's the whole joke. And all the while, you'll take detailed notes of its social patterns, mental capabilities, biological weaknesses. I want to know this specimen inside and out. I want you to fully dissect its behavior. If this opportunity turns out to be as full and ripe and juicy, sweet, yum yum goody, as I suspect. I'm certain the symposium's academic director will give us the keynote address to showcase your findings.
Professor, it sounds like you're asking me to lie.
Anything for tenure, Sandra. Anything for tenure.
I suppose you're right.
But I warn you, never let yourself get emotionally attached to a specimen. This is science, and only science.
All right, big cicada. I'll be leaving now.
I need to fuck.
Yes, don't we all? Not too bright, is it? Although, it is surprisingly attractive for an insect, isn't it? Perhaps we should all hang out together. Maybe Tuesday. It'll give you a chance to, you know, check in on how things are going. Sound good?
Okie doke.
Sound good, Sandra?
Okay.
All right.
Okay. Cicada hunk, first day in the apartment. Let me give you a tour. These things that you knocked over are called books, and they're fucking full of words.
Books?
This is a violin. It's very important to me because it was a gift from my father, who was taken from me when I was very young.
Violin?
Yes. This is a picture of my father, who was taken from me when I was very young.
Father.
This is a window?
Window.
These are my shoes.
Shoes.
That's about it.
Okie dokie.
Okie dokie.
Gertrude, send in the exterminator. Come in, Mr. Hounch.
It's pronounced henchman.
Right. Anyway, I have a special job for you. I think it's right up your alley.
Ah, oh, jeez. I already have a job, so I guess I probably can't do it. No,
I mean like another gig. It's not another job.
I can't. Oh, my God.
I know you have a job.
I thought you meant another. I know. I know, right?
Anyway, my bad. Listen, I have a young associate, a Miss Sandra, and she's made a new acquaintance. I would like you to go follow him.
And after I follow him, you want me to?
No. How did you get killed from follow?
I'm sorry. My bad.
That's my bad.
No. Right. My bad.
Right. Anyway, I want you to go follow him and just observe from a distance. Find out his intentions for me.
And after I find out what his intentions are, you want me to, keep it to myself and, or tell Sandra about it, or, oh, I pitch it to my book editor.
Nope. Definitely none of those. Don't keep it to yourself. Come to me.
Oh, yes, because then you'll know.
Don't. Do not tell her. That's most important.
Do you validate parking?
We do. I don't, though. Gertrude, I don't. I think it's a stamp system.
Thank you, Dr. Von Stiel.
No, thank you, Mr. Henchman.
Brilliant move.
Okay, let's get started. How do I teach a bug to hit on women?
I'm hungry.
Hey, that's something new. Something other than I want to fuck. Progress.
You want to fuck?
No. No, I do not. That was my bad. That was my bad there.
Oh.
Don't eat that. That's not food. No, that's a book! Books are for reading. That cheese is just for show. Put it down. No way, Jose. That's my dog. Hey, now's as good a time as ever. I'll show you what I've been working on. I made a pot of waffles. You want some? Here. Subject is nothing more than a hot, handsome, hard-bodied buffoon. I got my work cut out for me.
Ah, thanks for the grub, babe.
If you're ever gonna find a human mate, you've gotta learn how to act like a human. And judging by your 3-week lifespan, you've gotta learn fast.
Squamp!
I poop on the floor. I poop in the toilet.
Oh man, Kramer's funny. A bug's life, babe.
Most fashionable person, but even I know you're not going to attract a mate with this look.
But this is my natural look.
Subject still unaware that his nature will get in the way of his sex goal. We're going to try a different look. I want you to pick out some items first.
Okay.
This might take a while.
To admit, you look good.
I look good.
Hey,
if you want to have sex, you can't just say, I want to fuck. You have to take the person out on a date.
A date?
Courting is not intuitive to the subject as expected. Yes, a date. So when two people go out and they get to know each other and make sure the other person has good manners.
Okay. Like this. I think you call this a gift.
Ew. No. I mean, sorry, good instinct, but that's just sticks and leaves.
Oh.
Next time, try a HBO Go password or a box of chocolates.
I will look that up.
Okay. He's surprisingly sensitive for a cicada. You know, let's practice more. So, you know, tell me something about yourself.
I must fuck soon because I will die.
No, don't say that. That's too forward and abrasive. So
I don't need to fuck that soon.
No, maybe don't just start with fuck. Say, like, something about yourself, like where you live or something like that.
I live in a tree.
Yeah, perfect. That's perfect.
I live in a tree.
That's good. Do you have any roommates?
I have a million roommates.
Oh, because of all the bugs.
Yes, we're all bugs. Together.
That's good. Good job, subject. Ask me about myself now.
What is important to Sandra?
That's a really good question. You're learning. Well, tenure, for sure, is important to me. And knowing where my life is headed and that I have a good direction. What's important to you?
Well, I know where my life is going.
Mm-hmm.
I'll die soon.
Yeah.
So what's important to me is living. Now.
And how are we doing over here? Science tests. Can I get you two lovebirds anything to drink?
Birds? No birds.
Oh, no birds.
You said no birds.
No, there's no birds.
No.
Give me a minute. It's okay.
I live in a tree.
Oh, I know more about you than you would know.
I'm now running field experiments with the subject. He will be using small talk in order to court a mate. I've given him some tips to get him started. Hopefully, he will use them.
Hello, man. Sky is beautiful.
The subject seems to have a hard time with small talk and conversing with people. He does seem to be connecting with the target on a very innocent and primal level, though. Fascinating. Oop. He seems to be reverting back to his cicada ways. He needs to remember the small talk subjects I suggested before the experiment started.
Do you like Breaking Bad? Pogs? Internet? Pokemon? Hats? Tweets? Pizzas? Breaking Bad?
Perfect. Talking about Breaking Bad never fails. Subject might be learning after all.
This guy's great.
Lots of work to do, but I have to admit, I'm having fun. Subject is quite charming. Focus on the project, Sandra. Tenure, symposium.
I'm Rashida.
Sandra, you've never been this late. What's gotten into you?
Nothing. I'm the same as I've always been.
You smell like dirt.
The cicada hunk was showing me some dirt that he likes.
Sandra, you need to watch out, okay? He's a cicada. His lifespan is like, what, 2 weeks? This is only gonna end with you getting hurt.
I know, I know. Okay,
and if I didn't know any better, I think you're in love with him.
Absolutely not. I mean, I have my guard up just like I always have. I mean, that's impossible. That's never gonna happen. Nothing is gonna change. That's not possible. It's not going to happen, Rashida. You're out of line. That's not going to happen, Rashida.
I'm causing a scene.
It's not going to happen. Are you crazy?
Can you stop?
No, no way. It's not going to happen. You're crazy.
Okay,
you're crazy.
Whatever
it's
you
not
say,
gonna happen.
Right? Oh my God. Oh fuck. Oh man, it's all over me. It burns. Holy fucking Christ, my skin. Wow. It's so hot. Oh my God, why is it so hot? I was just drinking it, Sandra. Help me, get some like cold water or something. I don't know, like, I just had like a croissant come up in my mouth. Where did that come from? Oh my God, where's the bathroom? I've never been to this place. Hello?
Sorry.
Hey, Cicada Hunk. Do you remember being in torpor? Underground?
I remember blackness.
Do you remember coming up?
I remember your music, and I remember wanting to fuck.
Oh, right, because you thought the music was another cicada wanting to mate. Since you came up, do you dream?
What is dreaming?
That's when you're sleeping and your mind wanders and your brain kind of goes where it wants.
Oh, yeah, I dream.
What do you dream about?
Fucking and music, life. You? What do you dream about?
I dream about... getting tenure. And having a career, and bugs, of course, because that's my job. But this isn't about me, this is about you.
Subject is sleeping like a cute, beautiful stallion man. He's just sleeping. Obviously, Sandra, there's nothing to see here, nothing to report. A lot of work to get to. I love when he snores. So if you're going to couple with human women, you're going to have to learn to talk to them.
Well, why talk when you can dance, or fuck, or cover each other in sap, or fuck, and then die in a crunchy heap?
Cicada, you can't talk to women about that. Well, at least not at first. So tell me something else that you would like to talk about.
Sure. How about this pillow? Do you like this pillow, Sandra? Does this pillow make you want to take my seat? Or do you want to talk about these tree loaves? I want to talk about... Oh, wait. What's this?
Oh, that's a snow globe app. Humans like to put that on their phones during the holiday season. It makes them think of family. Or home.
What's going on in there? It's so white.
It's snowing. It's winter.
Winter. Winter. You know, I go underground in springtime. I come up and shed my exuvia in springtime. Even die in springtime. Don't think I'll ever see a winter. Do people fuck there?
Yes. Sometimes humans do. I'm sure. In that app, in that snow globe, within that cabin. If there were people in there, they'd be snuggled up tight.
I like winter. I want to fuck in it.
Cicada wants to see winter.
Wow.
Yeah. Well, there it is. The final episode of Entourage.
Wow. It was like a Greek play. Something I now know, thanks to you, Sandra.
Wow, you were progressing nicely, Cicada, hung.
And that's been really fun, catching up on the last 17 years with you and like, learning how to be human.
Yeah, it has been really, really fun.
Yeah, it's been a lot of fun.
It's been so fun.
What?
It's been really fun to spend time with you. Anyway, we should get going to the bar so that we can see if you really have what it takes to have sex with a real human woman.
As long as the bar has good craft beers, I think I'll be fine because I don't drink mass market beers. Don't put Coors Light in front of my face. I will send it back. Hey, what's that?
Oh, just human stuff.
Oh, cool. That looks like a police taser. Be careful with that. Black Lives Matter, Sandra.
All lives matter. But seriously, all jokes aside, racism is a major problem in America.
Black Americans are twice as likely than white Americans to be killed by police officers.
Black professors are 20% less likely to receive tenure than white professors in a similar field.
Out of the 500 billionaires in America, only two are African American. Oprah Winfrey.
And former NBA star Michael Jordan. But seriously, let's find a human pussy for you to fuck.
Sandra, you've done wonders with it. How is the experiment going?
It's coming along.
It is remarkable. Does it understand anything?
He, Professor. And yes, he has the capacity for learning.
And he ain't too bad in the eyes either, if you know what I mean.
I'm sure I don't.
Hey, say something smart, bug boy.
Priarian.
Okay. Yeah, very intelligent, Sandra. I warned you, wasting your time on a transformed cicada is a terrible move for your career.
This music. It's driving me crazy.
Tell me more, how so?
I gotta dance and move.
Wow. What kind of IQ are we talking about here?
It's hard to measure, actually, Ed.
No, it's no IQ. The cicada is known as a brainless insect. It has no capacity for anything other than sex and dying. Honestly, this poor guy doesn't even know that we're talking about him right now.
Okay, Professor, I'm sure he's not all that dumb.
No, really, he is. They say the brain mass is actually smaller than most root vegetables. Sandra, I don't know why you're wasting your time trying to teach it art and literature and the finer parts of culture when this thing knows exactly three things: fucking, pooping, and dying.
Hey! I may not be no eggheads like you guys, but I know what I know.
What is that?
I know, but a soft night in June feels like on the back of my shoulders. I know the sweet smell of lilacs in the meadow, and I know the sound of 1,000 cicadas ringing out like an angelic chorus, singing a song of eternal love into the night, sensual and forbidden. Now I gotta dance. Goodbye.
Go. Go.
You tossed him there.
No. That was him. All him.
I really love your wings.
I'm a cicada.
I'm a Gemini.
I just came out of the dirt yesterday.
That's so rad.
Breaking Bad is my jam.
I love Breaking Bad.
Do you want to fuck? I need to fuck a human woman.
I've never fucked a cicada before. I don't think.
It will be fun. I like doing it, and I'm pretty big where it counts.
Let's get out of here.
Sandra, let that bug go fuck that tart. We can think of more civilized things.
Oh, hey, Sandra has a bed just like this, too.
Something wrong?
No, you're a beautiful human person with skin.
Oh, so sweet.
Hey, I have an idea. Why don't you talk to me about, talk to me about winter.
Ugh, I hate winter. I'm so glad it's over.
Subject engaged. Several human females at a local drinking establishment, an initiated contact. Subject was received positively by human females. Subject went home with the trashiest of human females from the local establishment, not to editorialize or anything, I mean, doesn't matter, it's for the best. He's just a means to an end.
namely, tenure. Oh, I didn't think you'd be back so soon. You made it successfully.
I wasn't able to fuck.
What? Why?
I don't know. I made some big mistakes.
It's my fault. I didn't have nearly enough time to teach you the courting behaviors of humans. We'll schedule time tomorrow and I will show you how to...
You've already shown me so much. And for that I am grateful. Now it's time I show you something. Can I show you something? To show you how grateful I am?
I am not going to mate with you.
No, it's not fucking! It's something else.
Oh my god. The stars are so pure. The stars are so much brighter up here. I can see them reflected in your eyes. Your beautiful eyes. I told you I wasn't going to mate with you. I didn't say that to fuck. I said that because it is true to me. Oh, look! There's a university. From up here, it all seems so... insignificant. Unimportant. Wow, the view from up here. It's amazing. Yes, I come here sometimes to think about fucking. It would be a great place to fuck. Someone else, I mean. Yes. Not you. Yes, of course. So, where do you think you went wrong tonight? With that whore, what? That human female? From the bar. It is a mystery. I could not go through with it, and I also still do not know what 9/11 is. That came up again. But I am still not sure what happened on that date. What about all those beautiful things you said at the bar? How did you even know to say those things, by the way? It seems like it would have been very effective. I just know them. I have always known them. All cicadas know these things. Well, did you kiss her before you tried to put something in her? What is... kiss? Kiss? Sounds like piss. Kiss. Keys? Keys? No, that's something else. Kiss. My god, I can't believe I forgot to teach you about kissing. I'm so sorry. Kissing is when two people, or conversely, when one giant insect and a woman... You know what? It's just easy if I show you. This in no way means I intend to mate with you, okay? Yes, I understand. No fucking. That is what that woman tried to do to me. I thought she was trying to liquefy and drink my innards, as a spider does. Well, you don't need to worry about that. I would never do that to you. I like this kissing. Can we do this kiss again?
let's see what's on Miss Sandra's recording device. Have fun while you can. It won't last long, you disgusting bug.
Leave a message after the tone.
Sandra. Sandra, where are you? We had a symposium prep today at Sherbert's. We all showed our data. Not you, though. You weren't there at all. Are you okay? Listen, you were falling behind. The other entomologists are all ahead of you. Spending time with your cicada is fine, but that can't be your whole presentation. You've got to print out all kinds of things and set up your slideshow in Keynote and do the sound check. I can't just show my stink bugs, you know. I've got to show that they stink worse when you electrocute them. That's a presentation. That's a symposium. Ugh, whatever. If you want me to print stuff, just tell me. I've got a good, fast printer. But you've got to do the rest. Bye.
He looks so sad. I should go talk to him.
Do you smell that cicada hunk?
It's the spring beans. They're ripening. Summer's almost here. What do you have in your hand?
Nothing. Leave it be.
Show me.
Cicadas. They're dead and dying. They've reached the end of their life cycle, as old things do. I too will die soon, you know.
Shh. Come on. Let's go for a walk.
Ah! Ah!
Oh, I'm so sorry.
That's all right. My body is just very brittle and decaying, as nature is wont to do. Here, it doesn't even hurt that much. Do another one. Gah! It kind of feels good. I like shedding for you. Ah. Ah, fuck. Yeah, okay. Ah!
Look, cicada hunk! It's snowing!
You know, I've never seen snow. And it's likely I never will. There's simply no way that anybody on this earth, especially you, could ever provide me the opportunity to see snow.
And that's when I had my big idea. So I says to him, walk all the way home with your hands over your eyes.
Turn the other way. Turn towards my voice. To my voice. Okay, stop. Take your hands down. Ta-da!
Sandra, what's going on?
Don't you remember when you said you wanted to see winter?
Well, sure, but that was just a crazy dream.
Well, I brought winter home, baby.
Say what?
Could see. Winter snow, just every old place you look. It's just like in your snow globe, Sandra.
It's just like in your snow globe.
My God. Gifts from one little Christian to another. Angels fly above, presiding benevolent joy upon the snow-kissed land below. It's good. It's good what winter does. Oh, Sandra. Oh, Sandra, I need to fuck in it. Sandra, I need to fuck. Sandra, I need to fuck you.
Sandra. Oh.
Oh, yeah. Oh, you're so strong.
Well, well, well.
Oh, yeah. Oh, oh, my God. You're such a hunk.
Oh, you're so beautiful. You're so smart.
Oh, thank you.
God damn it.
Oh,
well, well, well. Hey!
Alvin? What are you doing here?
Oh, nothing. I just came by to tell you that I finally got a chance to steal your research and look it over.
What?
I stole your research and listened to it, Sandra. It's good. Very insightful. Trite, as usual, but really primo stuff. I especially enjoyed all the discussions about Specimen A. Do you remember what I'm talking about? I'll play it for you.
Calvin, don't.
But it's so good. Sincerely, it's your best work. So smart to take a cicada into your home and teach it things for your own personal gain. This is the kind of research that'll get you tenure at Symposium.
Tenure? Symposium? Sandra, what's he saying about with words?
Oh, he didn't know. How wonderful! A trick, a ruse, a prank! Elsie, you look confused. I'll explain it to you. You see, she used you to get tenure. Oh, what? You didn't think you were in love, did you?
Don't listen to him, Cicada. We are in love. I am in love!
Oh, really? That's strange, because most of the notes on this recorder don't sound very in love.
The hunk, I mean cicada hunk, I mean cicada de specimen. He has poor traction skills, inadequate flirtation capabilities, and is unlikely to mate.
And this is good too.
I took him to a bar. Courting is not intuitive to him.
Oh, and this one is my favorite.
I'm going to have to gain the subject's trust, make him think I'm invested emotionally. He enjoys winter? Perhaps I'll show him winter? For my own personal gain. For my own personal gain. Personal. Gain. Personal.
Oh, and it goes on like that. They're all pretty much the same after that. The gist is this, though. You are nothing but a bug to her. A bug that would win her a prize.
You tricked me?
No. Yes, I mean, it started out just being about the science.
I don't believe this!
Cicada, you don't understand! Cicada, you taught me!
I taught you? I didn't want to teach you. I wanted to fuck you. And you used me.
Cicada, you don't understand!
Oh, I understand perfectly. You know, I'm out of here.
Cicada, wait!
How could I? How could you? You fell in love with a bug over me.
He's more than a bug. He's a hunk and a cicada and the truest love I've ever known in my life.
It's a specimen. You might as well have fallen in love with a box of maze mice. I mean, honestly, what kind of scientist are you? Not a very good one, I'll tell you that much.
You don't know him.
Maybe not, but I know this. You will never be a real scientist and you will never fuck a cicada.
Hey, Bug Boy.
What do you want?
I got a proposition for you.
I don't know what that means.
I got something to tell you.
I don't know what that means.
Just get on the board.
Hey, it's me.
Sandra, where are you? You're supposed to be lecturing right now. I had to take over your class, and I'm just a janitor around here. Everybody's not pleased.
I quit. My career means nothing to me now that he's gone.
He? You mean the bug thing?
Cicada. He left. I'm so stupid. I should have fucked him the day I met him. And now it's too late. He's gone. I want you to go to my office and burn it to the ground.
What?
You heard. I'm done sciencing. Science means nothing to me without my sweet, sweet cicada friend.
Sandra, this is crazy!
If you ever want to see me, come to the woods. I'll be here playing the violin, alone.
I wish I could have warned you about her sooner, Cicada Hunk.
I thought we were in love.
Yes, it was a cold trick she pulled. I gotta tell you, that shit was cold as ice, baby.
Yeah, iceberg, baby. She got us good. She could get a job doing pranks down at the docks for little sailor boys.
Oh, yeah, she's a regular little liar, liar, pants on fire.
Yeah, man. And you know what? To be honest, when I first saw you two together, I thought this crazy lady's head over heels for a bug man. And I was like, that shit's weird! But then I was like, that shit's kind of nice.
I also thought it was kind of nice.
Yeah, and I was like, this is a perfect couple. Man and a woman. And they're gonna get a boat together. And they're gonna go to the sea. And they're gonna catch flounders.
Hey, whoa, 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 hold the phone here, all right? This guy's bitch ass is already to be dragged through the mud as enough as it is. He ain't gotta hear from us, too.
Mud? Yes, mud is where I belong. Safety in mud. Mud is where I came from.
Hey, you listen to me, you little shit. You gotta bust that nut, baby.
Who? Who am I going to bust my nut into? You? This guy?
Not me, man. I don't take nuts. Not anymore.
What if I told you that behind that door are three giant, beautiful cicadas? Huge, fat, natural tits.
Tiggle bitties.
Borderlining right in between natural and perky. Right in the middle, right in there.
You have cicadas with perfect hang time titties in there?
Listen, Cicada Hunk. For they are calling your name.
Oh, them titties sound nice! Go ahead and get them, Cicada Hunk.
No! I don't know! I don't know if I wanna fuck anymore!
What?!
Fuck! Hey! How you doing, Karen?
Hi, Karen.
Karen is a cicada?
No, she's just...
Ah! That shit pains me to the tip of my little cock right here! The fact that this so-called science lady is telling you like it is! You're forgetting about who you are! Don't you know?
Yeah.
You're a cicada.
Yeah. Buzz buzz.
Now tell me, what does a cicada do?
They fuck.
Absolutely. They go out there and they turn out every little slam piece they can because that's what you were born to do. Now go out there and do what you were destined to live for.
I can't wait to see these tits. Hey, it's dark in here.
Oh, I know. I know. It's perfect for fucking.
Fucking tree cricket ass bitch, right?
Fuck you, Ibush.
Tree cricket ass motherfucker.
So yeah, I mean, I don't know if any look like Natalie Portman, but they're in here. Mm-hmm. And if you just go right there. Just kidding, it's her up!
Hey, Professor? The door's locked. Weasel Man, where'd you go? Hello? Hello? Cicadas? Hello? Cicadas? Are you ready to fuck? My butt's ready to fuck your butt. My butt dick is hard. Hey, those aren't cicadas. What the fuck is shit that?
With me, not against me.
You are not letting me help.
You are not letting me help.
I know how to make.
You have to be so independent.
Oh my God. Oh. Look, we're done. We're done. Okay,
oh,
we got
okay.
it.
Okay, we're done. We got now, it. Finally.
Oh, don't be so vainglorious about this.
He's all tied up. He's fading fast. I'll go get the gas. Finish him off real fast.
No! No gas. I want it alive. Yes, I'm going to perform a live dissection in front of the greatest academics in the entomological field. I'm going to give them real science.
Wait. We're gonna chop him up while he's still alive?
Yeah, do you have a problem with that?
No, wait, not really.
Yes, we have a big problem with that.
I'm sorry, excuse me?
We said we are so hungry, we could eat a rat.
Rat? Yes. We are actually really hungry.
It's been a day.
We haven't had a break yet.
Been outside for hours.
Yeah.
Oh my, guys, I am so sorry. I legitimately forgot to give you your break.
It's okay.
It happens.
I feel terrible. Do me a favor. Go ahead, eat your rat. Before you do, if you could just wheel this guy into the operating theater,
sure.
That would be huge.
Okay.
Ugh, I'm a mess. I need to find my pomade and get ready.
Oh, you look good.
I don't look good.
No.
I have some stuff that you could use.
Thank you. You know what?
Wheel him. Wheel him, please. Don't make me do all this shit. Wheel him, thank you.
Teleportation. Molecular decimation, breakdown, and reformation is inherently perfect.
What are you doing? Get out of here!
You gotta help the bug.
Why would I help the bug? He hates me.
He doesn't hate you. He loves you.
Oh, right. Yeah, why don't you go steal another tape recorder, okay? You're so good at that.
Do you even love him?
Yes, I love him, okay? What are you doing? Get out of my fridge!
Do you love him?
I'm telling you! Show me!
Tell
me what's going on!
You don't know?
No, how the fuck am I supposed to know?
I know you're Cicada Hunk now. I've seen into his soul.
Oh God, swallow!
Your psycho professor is gonna chop him up.
Where is he? What's going on?
Professor's gonna rip his cock off. He's cutting him up.
Wait. At the symposium in a half an hour.
Half an hour? We have 30 minutes. We have 30 fucking minutes.
Oh God!
What are we gonna do?
I don't know. God, I love him. I never.
We have to save my cicada.
I was gonna kill every single bug, I ever known. I was like, I'm fine. I can kill your motherfucker. You're fine. And like, he did something to me. It was so easy to kill bugs for me. It's so easy, but not him. He did something to me.
He did something to me too. He did something to all of us! Oh God, yes!
Wires!
I'll tell you what we're gonna do. We're gonna electric with wires!
Ladies and gentlemen, entomologists of the highest degree, willkommen
to the main event, which will surely be the greatest symposium of all time. May I present to you the largest specimen of the cicada giganta ever seen. Many call this specimen a hunk, but I just would like to cut him open and study him. I will perform a live dissection. Any last words? Nine. And now, the first incision. What is that sound? Could someone shut that off? What is that? I'm about to make history. What is that sound? Violins? I hate violins. Ben! Stop! Do not leave! Remain seated! Bug Zappa?
Hey, Professor Shithead. Suck zaps.
Soldier!
Shh, I'm gonna get you out.
The exterminator. Exterminator! Sandra, so glad you had a chance to say goodbye to your precious tree cricket! Any last words?
Yeah. Your tenure's been revoked. Let's get out of here before the cops come.
Oh, Sandra, I'm dying.
I know, Patrick. I know. I'm taking you back to nature. Your home. I'm sorry I'm dragging you like this.
No, it's all right. As long as I'm with you, I feel no pain.
Can I tell you a story?
You could tell me anything.
17 years ago, when I was a little girl, my father took me to these same woods while the cicadas were out.
You see, Sandra, each of these insects loves each other, in their own way, if only for this one moment.
Bugs can love?
Don't say bugs. The word is insects. And yes, insects can feel emotion, like every other living thing.
Then isn't it sad they have to die?
Oh, not really, sweetheart. It's all part of nature, like you and me.
Are you gonna die, Daddy?
Oh, I hope not, sweetheart, but I am shipping out to Kosovo tomorrow. I hope to get back to you, but if I don't, I would like you to do something for me.
Okay.
Wherever you are, if you miss me, whenever it is, even in the middle of the night, I would like you to go out into the middle of the woods and play your violin.
Will you hear it?
Ah, of course, sweetheart. Wherever I am, I will hear it all around me.
I like that story, Sandra.
So, what happened to your father?
He was one of the four Americans killed in Kosovo.
I'm so sorry.
Come on, you don't have much time. We need to fuck.
No, it's okay. I no longer need to fuck. Because we've already made love.
No, this time I need to fuck. Right here. And we're doing it your way. Oh.
Shed my skin around you, shed your love I'm just a man who found you. Why can't I shed my feelings for you? I don't want to die alone, but if I die before I'm old, please promise me you'll find another love.
What happens now, Daddy?
We let them fall to the earth so that their children may burrow into the ground and come back again in 17 years.
Will you kiss them good luck?
Of course, sweetheart.
Sandra, before I go, take my wings.
Cicada Hunk, no!
Yes, play them and remember us.
Please, don't leave me.
I'm not leaving you. I'm only going away for a while.
But every 17 years, just listen, and you'll hear me.
Cicadas are complicated. They exist to live. They live to exist. You could say that on a superficial level, the cicada has evolved to fulfill one sole purpose: to procreate, to be functional. The world, is it just about function? It's about love. For 17 years, a cicada lives underground, unwilling, unable to see, to imagine the places, the people, the things in the world just beyond the surface. This is the life of the cicada. Alone in the dark, working and working for what? To see the beauty of life in the world for but a few weeks? The life of a cicada is like some kind of metaphor. Inside every living organism, there is a living, beating heart. Inside every winter lives a Christmas. Life is like a journey. And on my journey, I did receive tenure. But more importantly, I received love. Someone I knew long ago told me something I don't think I'll ever forget. He looked in my eyes. And he said, I need to fuck. And you know what? You know what? We all do.
Action.
Just give me a time to flip.
I almost thought he was soft.
Slide it out.
If you only had one shot. 1 5 to 6 week opportunity to seize anything you ever wanted. Would you capture it? Or would you let it slip? Let's go!
I need the fuck! I'm the cicada hunk!
Cicada.
I need the fuck! I'm the cicada hunk, important that I fuck!
Came from the dirt, fucking on my mind. Looking for a female cicada that likes fucking all the time. Only got a little bit of time, maybe 4 or 5 weeks. Find a fine ass cicada, gonna rub some ass cheeks. I'm a 17 year cicada, and I have red eyes. I only have a little bit of time to fuck before I die. I love some tree bark and a sap cover stick. And I know you all heard about my 1-inch dick.
I need the fuck. I'm the cicada, hunk.
Cicada.
I need to fuck. I'm the cicada hunk, important that I fuck.
Ow! I met a being named Sandra, a human girl professor. The only thing this organism wants to do is get tenure. Ow! I'm a hunky ass cicada with fucking on my mind. But Sandra says that I'm way too fucking coarse and unrefined. I said I came from the dirt and I really love sap. I suck on tree bark and I can motherfucking rap. She's teaching me about humans, how to be a human fucker. But I think I'm catching feelings and I'm starting to love her. Oh,
I need to fuck. I'm the cicada, hunk.
Cicada.
I need to fuck. I'm the cicada, hunk. Important that I fuck.
Said I came from the dirt. I thought it was to fuck. I didn't get to fuck, but I learned so much. I learned about science. I learned about love. I learned about Christmas and God up above. So listen to my journey and heed a special message. Winter is the time where we all should learn lessons. Wait, yo, that's Sandra. Man, I'm about to smash it. I'm a cicada hunk. My name is Patrick.
We got the fuck. I'm the cicada hunk.
Cicada.
We got some fuck. I'm the cicada hunk. Important that I fuck.
Ow!
Your mother! What are you gonna call them?
I need to fuck.
Hunk.
I need to
after their father.
You fucked my dad!
Fuck me, mommy.
I need to fuck me, mommy. Fuck me. I need to fuck.